we're back here at our step repair that we've done with our cement patch. And actually, it looks pretty good. Step came out really well. All of our other patches around the pool came out perfect. So we're gonna get going, and we're gonna start taping the tile line and the lights and the steps in the pool, and get ready for painting. Okay, we've reached that final point where we are ready to paint the pool. I just want to go over some of the items you'll need. Of course, painting is pretty obvious to most people, but when you're painting a pool, because it's always underwater, you do have to use special paint. You can't just go to Home Depot and buy paint that you would paint a wall with. We're using a product called Nelsonite Pool and Deck Coating. It's a high-build epoxy paint. It means that it's much thicker than ordinary paint. The thing of it is it's a two-part system. One is a solvent that you have to add to the paint. It helps with the curing process. If you don't add this, the paint's not going to cure, and when you fill the pool up, all the paint's just going to wash away. So every gallon of paint you get, you will get a quart of this solvent that you need to add to it. Obviously, you're going to need a roller. I like to use the thick nap roller. This is an inch and a quarter nap, they call this. This is really good because, again, it pushes the paint deep into all the little cracks and crevices in the pool, filling everything in one shot. Manufacturer does recommend two coats. However, I've been doing this for many years, and if the pool looks good when you're done, you don't really have to add another coat. If you choose to, that's up to you. I also have my cordless drill with a mixing stick on it. This will help in mixing the paint. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to dump in my paint, dump in my solvents, and I'm going to mix it up and get ready to do our trim work around our light, around our built-in steps, and around our steps up here in the shallow end. I'm going to pour it in my 5-gallon bucket here. Don't pour the solvent into the paint can. Pour it into a separate bucket and mix it up well. Okay, we're about halfway through mixing our paint right now. It's really starting to come together good. I just want to mention one thing about this. This is an invaluable tool. If you don't have this, you're never going to be able to mix up this paint. It'll take you 2 days to mix this paint. I've already been mixing this for about 5 minutes with this tool, and it still needs to go a little further. So we'll continue doing that, but invest in one of these. They're about $10, and it'll save you so much backbreaking work than trying to stir this with a wooden paint stick. So we'll go back to stirring. Okay, we've mixed up all of our paint, and we're gonna start painting. The first thing you need to know is you wanna start, obviously, in the deepest end of the pool, on the far back wall, and you wanna work your way out of the pool. This is so you don't walk back in and step on your wet paint. Just about finished here. We're just working on the shallow end of the pool. As you can see, it came out really good. We gave it one coat. We used about 5.5 gallons of paint for this particular job. I just want to go over a few things about the paint. Pool paint isn't your ordinary, you know, Home Depot paint. This stuff is specially formulated to be underwater for many, many years. It has a lot of different chemicals in it. I highly recommend following the manufacturer's directions to a T. Otherwise, you're going to end up with an absolute mess in your pool. Don't paint the pool in complete direct sunlight. I know sometimes you have to, but try to do it as late in the day or as early in the day as possible when the temperatures are cool and when the sun isn't just beaming down on it. That makes the paint harden and thicken much quicker. You get a shorter lifespan of the paint at that point. So you want to do it when it's nice and cool. You also don't want to mix too much paint at one time. I really recommend just doing a gallon at a time. Two people on a gallon of paint, you can get rid of that gallon pretty fast, and then you can go ahead and mix another gallon and another gallon. The hardener that we add to the paint begins to work immediately. The second you add it to that paint, it's starting to harden that paint. So you got to get it on the pool fast. So the less paint you have mixed, the better the quality is going to come out. So I'm just going to finish up here. I'm working my way out of the pool, and we're almost done. So we'll be right back. Okay, we finished painting the pool, and as you can see, it looks really good. The manufacturer recommends waiting 4 to 6 days before filling the pool. The paint has to cure properly. Otherwise, if you start to fill it now, the paint's just going to wash away. So we'll be back in 4 to 6 days, and we'll start filling it up. Well, we waited the 6 days, and then we filled the pool up, and as you can see, it looks really good. Two guys took one day to do it. This is a 30-year-old swimming pool here, and just with a coat of paint, it looks almost brand new. The water shimmers nicely. All we have to do now is vacuum it and add our chemicals. I'm not really going to go through all of the chemicals that you need to add right now. I just want to touch on one particular chemical, which is called conditioner or stabilizer. This is available at any pool store, or you can go to our website, poolandspa.com, and purchase it there. This is a chemical that stabilizes the chlorine reading in your swimming pool. It only needs to be added once during a fill-up. Well, I hope this video on how to drain and paint the pool was helpful to you, and you can go ahead and do this in your own yard. So for Pool and Spa TV, I'm Tim Casey, and happy swimming.